What hobbies have people started over the pandemic lockdown? Knitting. Learned how to knit on my own and through YouTube. One of my favorite things to do now is crawl into bed, listen to an audiobook and knit wool. Sewing. Started with face masks and then expanded into simple garments. As a beginner, it really helps to have someone in your life who is an experienced sewist. I happen to live with one, my husband. Also, YouTube is super helpful. Remodeling, not very good at it. But I'm learning. I'm learning Arabic for no reason whatsoever. Raising chickens, raising livestock in general, gardening, self-protection / gun ownership, all of which have increased in price for me by 100 to 400% in the last year. I taught myself to knit with the help of some YouTube videos. I went from making ugly dishcloths to making fancy hats and scarves for my nieces for Christmas. I was told I knit like an old lady. A lot of people started to make sourdough breads in my country. I have been doing some basic investing in shares. Nothing big, just to get a better understanding of the market, and how to grow wealth. I revamped my turntable setup and got more serious about record collecting. Mixing oils and scents for skin / hair care. Started by making beard oil. Once I had those ingredients, I was one away from balm, then chapstick, now it's soap. Currently experimenting to make a good soap with cheap ingredients. It's pretty simple, but surprisingly a lot of room for creativity and improvement. I make model tanks, and I fucking hate it. But I can't stop. Fixing my moped and modifying it. Yoga, home brewing, and I've recently fallen down the online class rabbit hole. I've got a lovely tea mead bubbling away while I study literature. Brewing beer. Guilt-free hibernation. It's now encouraged. Cooking, I guess. At least me, rolling eyes face. I learned how to cut hair. Not exactly a hobby, but my housemate appreciates it. Binge watching and baking, romantic face. I took up knitting for a while but then I had to stop because of my A-levels, the Finnish equivalent. Collecting and modifying Game Boys. Stares at my pile of hobbies I've barely touched over the past year and bursts into tears. Crying. Biking. And I see a lot of people are getting into TV writing as well. My wife became an expert bread baker. Sourdough, sourdough rye, pizza, panettone. Mine was teaching our child to count, read and write. Given that the top selling knife on Blade HQ in 2020 was a balisong, apparently Bali flipping. Finally got a smoker, have been trying to nail down my process / recipe for pulled pork shoulder. Very fun with super enjoyable results, but hard to do as much as I want since it takes a whole day and I work a whole lot. Not often I get a full free day that I can tend the smoker for 8 to 10 hours. But when I do get the chance, I have a great time. I picked up the guitar and am extremely happy that I did so. I have also started reading again, which I haven't done in ages. I have read 23 books since March last year, a number that I only want to increase throughout this one. Lego collecting. Also trying different art stuff. I have been working normally the whole way through, but I started painting to de-stress, on my days off. Half an hour later, I was ready to burn the house down. How the hell do you mix green, to get a proper grass color? Happy little trees my arse. I wouldn't call myself a painter, no. I've started mountain biking, try go 2-3 times a week depending on how much spare time I have. Gardening store was packed. Amateur fish sellers are all out of stock. Learning to cheat during online school. Longboarding. It's a lot of fun and good exercise. Losing weight through exercise and dieting. Lock picking. You can get lock pick sets online with locks that have clear plastic casing, so you can see the mechanics of the lock and practice before moving on to real locks. It's really fun and challenging, requiring a degree of patience and a lot of practice. You have to learn to feel out the lock, and get used to picking by feeling more than by sight. Painting bloody endless amounts of space marines. It's infuriating and relaxing at the same time. Console gaming. Lock picking. I've always wanted to rock crawl with a Jeep, but couldn't afford it. I've started RC crawling with scale trucks and now I can do it on a small scale with some pretty cool RC trucks. All in my backyard too. I work at FedEx. Gaming PCs and weightlifting. Also I guess the art of using an air fryer lol. I was able to finally get my first woodworking workshop, and I fixed up my dad's 1960s racing bike and have been using it the last summer and just started again last week, as the streets are finally free of snow again. Gardening. My mom and I started 4 new flower beds last May, and almost every weekend we went flower shopping. I now have 6 beautiful flower gardens, with another coming soon, and starting vegetables later this year. Binge watching more than 8 episodes in a day. Skateboarding. DM typing this a couple hours after I just bombed my favorite hill. Collecting Steam games. I started journaling. Hamsters. Picked back up reading, instead of spending all my non-work hours watching Netflix. Also have gotten into art by numbers. It's really relaxing to me, requires focus and precision, and they look good enough to hang up. Keeping fish, the tanks are starting to take over, grimacing face, upside down face. I've really thrown myself into video editing and learning how to properly color grade footage. Also learning about color theory and stuff. The reason I did was because I also really got into solo backpacking and brought my cameras out with me everywhere, so I started making travel videos. And because I was hiking so much, and doing video things, I decided to try my hand at making reviews of ultralight backpacking gear. It's been fun. We'll be right back.